What's up, family? What's up, family? How y'all doing? It's your boy, Urban Sports Guru. I want to holler at y'all about the NCAA tournament. And, it's called March Madness for a reason. I mean, it's absolute madness. It's chaos. And much like I told y'all in previous years, the reason why we're seeing so much more chaos than before, when you take a year where the McDonald's All the Class McDonald's All Americans weren't really a bunch of superstars, when you take a year after year after year, these guys going one and done and leaving, the talent pool in the NCAA has dropped. We have a 15 seed. Oral Roberts is in the Sweet 16. The disparity between a 15 and a 2, they beat number 2 seed Ohio State. The disparity between a 15 and a 2 used to be so grand. A 15 could never beat a 2. Could never ever beat a 2. The disparity, the gap between them just athletically was so grand. Because of recruiting. Not even going to go to coaching and all, just because of recruiting. But now, when you have, almost 30 years now of high school to the pros and one and done, and a bunch of kids getting drafted who, prior to all this, probably would never made it. You know, when I think about how many they're going and play out a rookie deal and then flame out. You know, it's good because you want to see brothers eat. And I respect that. But this is where the fans benefit. The fans benefit here. Why? It's more chaos. Secondly, the entire tournament is in the state of Indiana. So you don't have the travel issues that would be in every other tournament. Like case in point, Gonzaga, the original Cinderella. People talk about Oral Roberts being the Cinderella. Gonzaga's the original Cinderella back from the 90s. They're a team that originally went on the first Cinderella run, and now they've basically done this year after year after year. As the talent pool continued to drop to the point where Gonzaga is now a powerhouse. And the reason why they're the favorite, my favorite, to win it all, they're just not a well-coached team that executes. They now get pros. Gonzaga has actually put out pros. From Adam Morrison to the kid on Portland. They've almost won a national championship a couple of times. They actually get McDonald's All-Americans now. They went from Cinderella to now. They're a bigger powerhouse than UCLA. 30 years ago, who would have thought that? Think about it. And you would have sounded like a fucking idiot if you would have said that 25 years ago. When they had their first Cinderella, I'm like, watch. 20 years, they're going to be better than UCLA. They'd have laughed you out the gym. But this is what's happened because the talent pool has gone down. And you see more chaos. You see more madness. And there are a lot of bookies that are making a lot of money. So that's explained this year's NCAA tournament. Plus, you don't have the travel benefits. Everybody's in the same area. Like, Baylor's in the South. Baylor's doing what they're supposed to do so far. So far, they're doing what they're supposed to do. And they're controlling things. They will have even more of an advantage in the South because certain teams will get put in that South bracket that aren't from the South. How does that benefit? If you're a team that's from the South and you're the number one seed in the South, then now your fans are closer to the venues you're going to be playing in, which would make it more accustomed to like a home game. That's where it benefits. I know this as a Duke fan. Because when Duke has a team that can compete for the championship, they always get the number one seed in the East. And they're playing it either at the Barclays or Madison Square. North Carolina to New York, not a long drive. A doable drive. They come up from Durham. They come up. This is how I know. So just, I expect even more chaos. Still kind of leaning on Gonzaga to win it all. Right now, the NCAA is a crapshoot. And this year, the fan is the winner because you get complete excitement because you don't know what the hell is going to happen. That's my take. It's your boy, Urban Sports Guru. I'm out. Salute.